Y'all, I'm out here smashing. So hungry. I was on my way. Well, I had to go to the library, meet my client there, help them with some social skills there, and get some things that they needed. And now I'm having my mini lunch break. And after that, I will be going back home, getting myself ready for my notary signing that I have to do. So I'm going to be jumping from one career to the next, but that's okay. God is able, and I thank God for it, because there was that one point in my life that I could not get a job. I mean, everything I would touch would not go through. So I'm so grateful to have the opportunity for people to give me jobs, and not only that, to create jobs. So anyhow, this brought me to my next topic or thing that I'm going to say. Sometimes people think that you're going to fall off just because they out the picture. They think that you only got to a certain point because of them. Not understanding that we got a whole creator, not a half, not a partial. You know, some people do partial entities. They have to go to different I serve a true and a mighty God that gave me everything that I needed. You know, you was not my source. You got to tell people, you are not my source. If you don't help me, I promise you, God is going to send somebody else who will. Long as I have an open heart and I follow him, guess what? It doesn't matter what you do. It don't matter what you do. Somebody else is going to have to open up. God knows everything anyway before we even begin. And not only that, you are not God. So don't put me in your captivity bubble thinking that me or anybody else for that matter, thinking that they're just gonna fall off or they can't be anything without you. I used to remember when people used to tell me, you'll be nothing without me. How is that even so when I was something before I met you? You know, how is that even possible? You know, if that was true, if I was nothing, then why are you around me? Why did you even make yourself around me? Was it to make yourself look better? Some people do that. But it always backfires in their face. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, sweetheart. Don't worry about it. All I know is you are not my source. You got to tell people you are not my source. And that's not to be hateful. That's not to be mean. That's not to be bitter. You are not my source. You are greater than any limitation that somebody has put on you. I tell my clients that all the time. And I remind myself that all the time. Because I remember there were times when people tried to say, oh, you wasn't good enough. You wasn't that. And you know what? God stepped in and showed every single time that that was a lie. Casting all those vain imaginations right back down. So hopefully you guys take that with you. Don't let anyone put you in a bubble. And remember, even if someone does not like or agree what you're doing, they are not your source. So, yeah, hopefully something I said or done will help you on your journey. Please stay tuned to Journey to Jerusalem. Bye.